Member for New Westminster.
Yesterday, the Minister of Health stood up to defend his decision to close acute care beds in Fraser Health, the fastest growing region in British Columbia. 35 beds at Surrey Memorial, 11 more in Burnaby, 10 in Chilliwack, 10 at Peace Arch, and there's more. The minister claimed that closing residential care beds, closing acute care beds, was a good thing because they're creating residential care beds. Except, Honorable Speaker, Fraser Health's own 10-year plan said that 1,518 residential care beds should be added by 2015, another broken Liberal promise, Honorable Speaker. How can the minister claim that falling short by nearly 1,000 residential care beds is something for this government to cheer about?
Minister of Health.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker, and I said yesterday, I'll say again today, that Fraser Health is making sure that the services that they provide to the patients in their health authority is in fact the services those patients need. And the fact is that about 10 to 11% of patients in acute care beds are those seniors that are waiting for residential care placement or to be repatriated back to home with increased supports. Honourable Speaker, what Fraser Health is doing is providing the supports in community with 413 new beds in the community just this year alone. That will provide opportunities to relieve the stress on acute care hospitals, making sure the patient flow is seamless and providing the appropriate care for people in residential care.
Member for New Westminster on a supplemental.
Honourable Speaker, the Minister of Health conveniently ignores the fact that this government has already broken its promise and is 1,000 beds short of what they promised 10 years ago. And let's remember who we're talking about, Honourable Speaker. These are our parents, our grandparents, and our loved ones at the most vulnerable point in their lives. And the minister's rhetoric, frankly, is cold comfort for seniors in Fraser Health who are waiting for residential care or home care. According to the January report of the Seniors Advocate, the demand for beds, residential care beds in Fraser Health has grown three times faster than the beds that have been put in place. And that means seniors are waiting longer for care. And when it comes for home care, seniors are pleading for more hours that they cannot get. So once again, the government is giving with one hand and taking away with the other. How can the government possibly defend its own actions when seniors are not getting the care and the dignity and support that they deserve?
Minister of Health.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Honourable Speaker, you can talk to MLAs that have been in this House for a long period of time, and they will tell you there was a time when every day in their offices, in their constituency offices, people would come in because they could not find a placement for their father or their mother or their elderly aunt or their husband or their wife. Honourable Speaker, that was a daily occurrence in the constituency offices of MLAs in British Columbia. Since 2001, Honourable Speaker, we have added 7,400 publicly subsidized residential care, assisted living, and group home beds. Honourable Speaker, no longer do we have a lineup of people to get into constituency offices finding a place for their parent or their loved one, because we have filled that gap, Honourable Speaker, and will continue to invest in resources in seniors care in this province.